Inshallah, just 5 minutes, inshallah, left for Salat al-Asr, if somebody can wait. If you go on to, if somebody wants to do Sunnah, they can do Sunnah. But I would like to also add to this miracle of opening the chest of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, another evidence. And I'm saying all these things because we are in a time and a place and an age where so many doubts, shak, shukuk, are being raised, to doubt everything that relates to Islam and its Prophet and its miracles and its basics and fundamentals. This is the trend nowadays. And that is why I mentioned to you all these kinds of evidence to prove things. When I talked about historical proof that these miracles happened, Prophet ﷺ, and from the natural point of view that many miracles have happened to many prophets before him, and also from the common sense and logical point of view that Allah is capable. He is the one who puts these rules and physical rules that govern everything on this earth, and He is the one who is able and capable of breaking them at any time for any person, for any reason that He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, deems necessary. But also from the scientific and medical point of view, nobody at that time ever thought or could imagine that a person can have his chest open, his heart taken out, his heart opened, and then put back together. This was not heard of at any point in history and was not even imaginable to the people who narrated these stories. Okay? But nowadays, we can see this happening every day. Thousands of cases, open heart surgeries are being done. Okay? Now, at the time, people had so much strong iman, they never doubted these things. Now that we see these things happening in front of our eyes, and human beings are doing it to other human beings, still people are doubting the miracle of the Prophet ﷺ, as if the capability and power of human beings is better, stronger than the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, astaghfirullah. Not only that, nobody ever thought or knew that human flesh or skin can be sutured back. And this is the medical way now. Up till now, this is the way surgeons do their surgeries. When they're done, they suture layer after layer until everything is back together. Even the Sahaba, during the battles, the many battles they were in during life of Prophet ﷺ, you will not find a single hadith in which somebody was treated with suturing. Bring me a single hadith in which any Sahabi was injured and they had any idea about suturing. Never, never. Nobody had an idea. And they didn't have the antiseptic techniques. And if they sutured him, he would die of infection anyhow. Now, at that time. But I'm just saying that even Allah has given us scientific evidence that we can see in front of our eyes by the fact that there's open heart surgery. That Prophet ﷺ talked about a technique of suturing and opening the heart and opening the chest. Open heart surgery at a time when this was unimaginable. If your heart is open, then you die. And that's what they thought. The children thought he was killed. But still, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown us. What time is it now? Is Asr time already here? Okay, inshallah. We'll stop here. Time for Asr, Adhan. Okay. Oh, 3 minutes? Okay, I'll talk a little bit more then. Okay, we have a couple more minutes. Okay, 2 more minutes. Also, he said his mother saw light come out from her and go to Asham. Asham is the countries of Syria, Palestine, Jordan, Lebanon, this area. But the center is Jerusalem. The center is Jerusalem, Al-Quds. And scholars say that Islam started in Mecca. But eventually, the stronghold and the second coming back of the strength of Islam will be from Asham, according to the many ahadith, many narrations from Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Even Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, one time, he saw that the pillar of the deen, it's like a pillar, was taken from underneath the cushion he was sleeping in, and it was the angels took it to Asham. The fact that Asham is a special place, according to the many texts that we have in the Quran and Sunnah, it's also mentioned, Al-Ard al-Mubaraka, in the Quran, Al-Ard al-Lati barakna fiha, lil-alameen. The Baraka in Asham, also Al-Malaika basitatun ajnihataha ala Asham, in Allah takaffar li bi-Asham wa ahli, many ahadith about Asham, that the angels are pleased with the